Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm continuing the series on how to make money selling low or no content books on Amazon KDP. So if you want to make sure you don't miss any of the other videos, go ahead and click the subscribe button right now and the little bell next to it, and that way you'll be notified anytime a new video comes out. In today's video, I'm going to go over how to find a niche for your Amazon book. And the key is to find something that's low competition, but that people are still searching for. All right, let's get started. Okay, so to do my Amazon research, I use two self-publishing titans Chrome extensions, and these are free. So to download them on Chrome, I'll just need to click up here on these three dots, go to More Tools and Extensions. Then I'll click on these three little lines up here and come right down here to Open Chrome Web Store. If we search the store for self-publishing, it should pop up right here, Self-Publishing Titans. And these are the two we'll need. So I'll click on the first one, and then you can just hit Add to Chrome. Now, once you have both of them installed, you'll see them right up here in your extensions list. If you're not seeing them, choose this little puzzle piece. Make sure to pin them by clicking on the blue pin. After they're installed, I need to think of a broad search term. Maybe it's a good idea to make a notebook for a dog lover. So I'm just going to type dog lover in the Amazon search and see what comes up. Now, the Self-Publishing Titans expander will give you a lot of different ideas about dog lovers. And these represent searches that people have done on Amazon. And I'm just going to go ahead and download all suggestions. When I do that, it'll come in as an Excel file right down here at the bottom of my screen. And then I'm just going to click on that, and that'll open it in whatever spreadsheet program that your computer has. So here are all the different ideas. I'm going to go ahead and select all these and then just copy them with Command C. And then I'll open up Google Sheets. I just find Google Sheets a lot easier to use, and I use it a lot for my business. Now, if you don't have numbers or another spreadsheet on your computer, you can actually just go to Google Sheets and do File Open and then navigate to this in your downloads and it'll open it. I have a spreadsheet that's set up specifically for this. So I'm going to click in column 2 and just paste in that whole list. And now I'm going to get rid of everything in here that I don't need. For example, dog lover coffee mug is not something that I want to sell. I want to sell a notebook for a dog lover. I'm going to go ahead and sort these so they're in alphabetical order. So I'll go to data, sort range, and sort range from column A. And I'll just go through here and delete the ones that I don't want. Okay, so we have a lot of ideas, and now we need to figure out which of these keywords is a good niche for our book. So what I'll do now is I'll just copy this first one and I'll paste it into Amazon. And now the other Self-Publishing Titans extension is going to figure out if this is a good keyword for us to make a book for. And it actually takes some time, but once it's done, it'll give us a lot of different results. So a bestseller rank, the reviews, the price. But I always look right here at the keyword niche score. Now right here, you can see there are 100,000 results for this keyword on Amazon. And we are looking for something that's either 1,000 or 2,000, sometimes 3,000 is okay. So this keyword is just way too competitive. Okay, so I'm gonna go back to my keywords list and I'm gonna put 100,000 right here. And then the rank will be 18. And for the rank, we're looking for about 45 and up. Anything 50 and over is pretty good. But I'll usually highlight the keyword if it's 45 and up. This one is 18, so this one has way too much competition and not a great rank. So this is not one that I would use as a keyword when I'm entering my keywords in my listing. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and go through the process of getting results for all of these. Okay, so I have the results in rank filled out for each of the keywords, and now I'm going to go ahead and sort these by order of results. So to do that, I'm going to select that range and then go to Data, Sort Range, and we'll go to Advanced Sorting Options. I'm going to sort by column B, which is our results. and I'll hit sort. So now they're in order based on the results. We have three different keywords that actually drew 1,000 results. 1,000 is a very good amount of competition, and you really don't want to go too much below 1,000 because that means that not enough people are actually searching for that niche. And then if it's over 3,000, you're going to have trouble with people ever being able to find your book. It'll also be harder to rank your book, meaning getting your book on the first few pages of Amazon when someone searches for your keyword. So really the sweet spot is your results should be around 1,000 to 2,000, and your rank should be over 40. Now, we only have the good results for about three of our keywords, and that is in that 1,000 range. But our rank, we really only have one out of all the keywords we searched for that matches the rank that we need, and that is dog lover gifts for men, pit bull. But you'll notice that this other one is dog lover gifts for women, pit bull. And so these are both good keywords to build a book around. So I would probably just go ahead and target both of these keywords for my niche. So maybe I could make two low content books. One, the cover shows maybe a pit bull and some text that says, I love pit bulls. I could put lots of hearts, maybe I'll make it pink, and that'll be the one for women. And then the other one could have a more masculine cover for men. Now, there are other ways to go about finding a niche, but using these two free extensions has always worked pretty well for me. Now, in the next video, I'm going to go over how to set up your file with Adobe Photoshop and InDesign. So if you want to see that one, make sure you subscribe. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.